In this video, I will be discussing a question that we have been receiving quite frequently recently, and that is whether or not the CR1 or IR1 is faster than the K1. And so we know that for anyone who's beginning their immigration journey, picking the path that you'll take for your case is sometimes the hardest part. That and then also the wait time to be able to get through the process to be together. But picking your path we know is difficult, and this is a question we've been receiving frequently as to what's the fastest path and what's the fastest way to be together. And so before I dive into that topic, I'd like to take a moment to introduce myself and our firm. My name's attorney Megan Pastrana from Corrado Pastrana, the immigration firm for couples. We are dedicated exclusively to assisting couples in navigating the immigration process, from fiancé visas and counselor processing to adjustment of status, all the way through to removal of conditions and naturalization. And so we know how important it is for you to have valuable information about what's going on in the world of immigration as it relates to couples, and then also general information about the process. So if you haven't already subscribed to our channel, please do so now. We provide weekly updates and videos about immigration as it relates to couples. And then we also have a Facebook group called Immigration for Couples, and the link will be below if you'd like to join us. We have free educational information on our Facebook group and weekly live chats. We also have free resources on our website, and I'll post the link for that below as well. But yes, we'd love to have you subscribe to our channel and join our Facebook group so you can get all the important information you need. And last but not least, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, because it'll allow YouTube to share it with other couples going through the process who can benefit from the information. So let's dive in. Is the CR1 faster than the K1? So there's a lot of rumors right now that the CR1 is faster. And so I really want to break down where I think that rumor came from and what the truth is and what is actually in your control as a couple in choosing the path that's best for you and for your immigration journey. And so for those of you who are just beginning your immigration journey, maybe you haven't heard of the CR1 or the IR1. And so I'd like to quickly explain what that is, what the difference is. Basically, anyone who's married to a United States citizen or lawful permanent resident is eligible to become a lawful permanent resident themselves. And so the visa that's issued is a CR1 if the marriage is less than 2 years. And if it's more than 2 years, there's an IR1, which is an immediate relative. And then the K1, again, if you're new or just beginning your immigration journey, the K1 is a fiancé visa. And so this year, the year 2020 has been crazy. COVID, presidential proclamations, it's just made the world of immigration, which is always stressful, even more stressful, even more complex. And so there were presidential proclamations released in the summer of 2020, in April and June, suspending the entry of certain immigrants into the United States. With those proclamations, it was clear that individuals that were married to United States citizens or lawful permanent residents were allowed to enter the United States, but there was confusion about whether or not K-1 fiancé visas were excluded, or if they were allowed to be able to complete a process and enter the United States like CR1 and IR1. So by the end of June, beginning of July, we got clarification. The Department of State was notified, or provided notification rather, that K-1s were not on that list of individuals who were in the presidential proclamation, that they weren't banned from entry. So the K-1 individuals going through the K-1 process have had additional hurdles and additional confusion in their process, because there was a few months where it wasn't clear about whether or not they were going to be allowed to complete a process to enter. But we now have clarification, and we have other videos on our YouTube channel that explain that the K-1 visas are not part of that presidential proclamation. But because of all of that that happened this summer, this is my understanding, or this is where I believe that people are confused, individuals are confused in thinking that the CR1 or the IR1 will be faster, because there's still confusion about the fact that K-1 visas were on that presidential proclamation. And so I think that some people are under the misconception that K-1 visas are being treated differently at U.S. embassies and consulates. But the reality is that the truth of the matter is that U.S. embassies and consulates across the world are basically closed for routine services. they are scheduling interviews, and we're starting to see some U.S. embassies and consulates work on taking steps towards resuming normal routine processes and scheduling expedite interviews. But the reality is that K-1, whether you're going through a K-1 fiancé visa process or a CR1/IR1 process, there isn't a preference to either. Neither one is being given preference. Basically, it's been clarified that both paths, both individuals or individuals going through either process are able to complete the process and able to enter the United States. But the reality is that embassies and consulates are in large part closed or have very minimal interviews that they're scheduling. And so there's a clog in the system, regardless of whether you're doing a CR1 IR1 or whether you're doing a K-1 fiance visa. So that's the harsh reality, is that the embassies and consulates are closed or have limited services. And so it's not true that the CR1 or immediate relative or IR1 is faster than the K-1. That's not true. And there really is, to be honest, there really is no way to say that one of those paths is faster than another. But here at our firm, and the advice that we give to our clients and individuals beginning in the process is, let's focus on things that we can control. And what we can control is picking a path and taking steps forward, getting your application filed and getting you in line. And the idea is that we tell all of our clients here at our firm, we know that the immigration process is stressful. Basically, everyone in our firm has gone through an immigration process, and we know that it's stressful and how important it is for you to be able to be with your family and be together with your spouse and start your future. But we want to stay positive, and we want to focus on the things that we can control, and picking a path, whether that's a K-1 or a CR1, and getting your application filed and getting the ball rolling, that's in your control. And that's definitely something that you can do and take those steps forward to be one day closer to being together. And so we have other information on our YouTube channel about comparing both the CR1 and K-1, but the main thing in this video that I want people to know is that it's not true that the CR1 or IR1 is faster than the K-1. There are definitely benefits, pros and cons to each option. And like I said, we have other videos on our YouTube channel and resources on our website. And of course, you're welcome to schedule an appointment with one of our attorneys to discuss the pros and cons of each option and decide which option is the best for you and your spouse or fiance, and what path that will be best for you and in your immigration journey. And so again, the link below to schedule an appointment with one of our attorneys is below. And then you can also check out the other videos on our YouTube channel and the free resources on our website. But we just want to make sure that you know, I want to make sure that you know this important information, so you're not making a decision solely on the rumor that CR1 or IR1 is faster than a K-1 visa. So I hope you found that helpful, and give it a thumbs up so YouTube will share it with others if you've enjoyed this video. Take care.